Hello everyone, I am Purva Sharma, an undergraduate student of BSc Forensic Science from Government Institute of Forensic Science, Nagpur. Today, I'll be explaining you one of the most important technologies in forensic physics, that is, remote control technology. So let's get started. Remote, a word very known to us. We use it almost every day. So what does the word remote actually mean? Remote simply means far away in distance, and thus remote control implies having a control over something from a definite distance. In electronics, a remote control or a clicker is an electronic device used to operate another device from a distance, usually wirelessly. We operate devices like TVs, ACs, doors, DVDs, players and other appliances using a remote just sitting at our sofas. So let's see how this technology, which is very much a part of our daily lives, came into existence. The first use of remote control technology dates back to the period of World War I. The world's first remote control were radio frequency devices that directed German naval vessels to crash into Allied boats during World War I. World War II saw little advancement with bombs being detonated with a remote. But by the time the war ended, scientists were all running behind this great technology to get a good use. And today, we are using this technology for operating almost everything. And hence, it's very interesting for us to know how a technology that has made our lives so simpler actually works. So this takes us to the next slide, that is, how modern day remotes work. The modern day remotes that we use today are either based on infrared technology or radio frequency technology. We'll discuss both the technologies in detail, but before this, let's understand what is the basic principle behind this not so simple technology. When it comes to television and home theaters, the technology that we use is infrared. An infrared remote uses light to carry signals from the remote to the device it controls. It emits pulses of invisible infrared light that corresponds to specific binary codes. These codes represent commands such as power on, volume up, or channel down. The control device, also called as the receiver, decodes the infrared pulse of light into binary code that its internal microprocessor understands. Once the signal is decoded, the microprocessor executes the command. The transmitter of the remote sends out pulse of IR light that represents certain specific binary codes. These codes correspond to some specific commands which we want to give, such as volume up, volume down, power on or power off. The receiver in the TV or the device we want to control then decodes the pulse of light into binary data, which is made up of zeros and ones, which is then processed by the microprocessor of the device. The device then finally exhibits the command. The basic parts involved in this overall process are buttons, indicated circuits, button contacts, and light emitting diodes. Here in this picture, you can see two images. The right one depicts the back of the button, which resides on the button contact depicted in the left image. On the front end, the remote has an LED to send out pulses. A remote also has an integrated circuit and capacitors. The process works something like this. You push the volume up button. This makes the button touch the button contact right beneath it, completing the volume up circuit on the circuit board. This is detected by the IC, which then sends the binary volume up command to the LED at the front end. The LED sends out a series of light pulse corresponding to volume up command. These signals carry certain additional information as well, such as a start command, a command for volume up, device address so that the TV knows the data is intended for it, and a stop command which is triggered when you release the volume up button. When the infrared receiver on the TV picks up the signal from the remote and verifies from the address code that it is supposed to carry out this command, it converts the light pulse back into the electrical signals for 001-0010, that is for volume up. It then passes the signal to the microprocessor, which goes about increasing the volume. The stop command tells the microprocessor it can stop increasing the volume. One example of remote control codes is the Sony Control S protocol, which is used for Sony TVs and include the following 7-bit binary command. Here on the screen, you can see binary command and their corresponding commands. infrared remotes have a very short range, that is about 30 feet, which is very less as compared to what is used by the radio frequency remote control system, and they require a line of sight. To avoid interference caused by other sources of light which are present in the surrounding environment, such as the sunlight or the bulb or the human body, the infrared receiver on the TV or the control device only corresponds to a particular wavelength of light, which is generally 980 nanometers. This is all about infrared radio control, infrared remote control. Now let's understand about radio remote control in brief. Radio frequency remote control are very common in garage door openers or car alarm fobs or radio control toys, but their application is not just limited to these things. They have a wide range of applications, which we will see later. Let's understand how the process of radio remote control work. Instead of sending out light signal, an RF remote transmits radio wave that corresponds to the binary command for the button you are pushing. A radio receiver on the control device receives the signal and decodes it. This is an illustration of a radio remote control. The best thing about the radio remote control is its range. It can transmit up to 100 feet from the receiver, which is far more than the range of the infrared remote control. And radio signals can go through walls as well. Cell phones, walkie-talkies, Wi-Fi setups all transmit radio signals at varying frequencies. Radio frequency remote control also face the interference issue, which is addressed by embedding digital address codes in the radio signals and by transmitting at specific radio frequencies. Both the technologies, that is the infrared remote technology and the radio frequency remote control technology, have various use in various fields in industries. A remote control is used for controlling substation, pump storage, power station and HVDC plants. For these systems, often PLC systems working in long wave range are used. Garage and gates. Garage and gates are opened using remote control in US, Australia and UK. This technology is less common in countries like India. Military. The first reported use of remote control was done by military in the World Wars. Nowadays, remote controls are used for controlling military vehicles. Apart from this, remote controls in military usage employs jamming and countermeasures against jamming. Jammers are used to disable or sabotage the enemy's use of remote control. One interesting thing about the use of remote control in military is that the distance that military remote control works upon is far much than what the household radio controls use. It is up to intercontinental distances. US has successfully used satellite linked remote control up to an intercontinental distance for their unmanned airplanes in Afghanistan, Iraq and Pakistan. Space. Remote control technology is also used in space travel. For instance, the Soviet Lunokhod vehicle were remote controlled from the ground. Photography. Many action cameras such as GoPros as well as standard DSLR including Sony's Alpha series incorporate Wi-Fi based remote control system. And finally, the last but not the least, the usage of remote control by the law enforcement agencies. Devices such as remote operated vehicles for underwater search and tactic robots for navigating barricaded buildings allow officers to see and even hear what is happening in an environment without physically entering the space themselves. This cuts down on the time spent on calls and helps keep officers and citizens safe. This is all about the remote control technology. Thank you.